At is Boumediene versus Bush. In a dangerous decision, the Supreme Court, by a close 5-4 vote, ruled that non-Americans, not held on American soil, even if they are enemy combatants, still get the protection of our Constitution and habeas corpus. Never in our history have we afforded men who are trying to kill us and our soldiers full protection of the very Constitution they are trying to topple.
Oh, really, Mr. Manweller? Well, perhaps you've forgotten about the Nuremberg trials at the end of World War II. The plan for the trial of European war criminals was drafted by Secretary of War Henry Stimson and the War Department. Following Roosevelt's death in 1945, the new president, Harry S. Truman, gave strong approval for a judicial process. Harry S. Truman, a U.S. president, a U.S. leader, gave strong approval for a judicial process. Just as Robert Jackson played an important role in not only the trial itself, but also in the creation of the International Military Tribunal. Though the IMT rejected this on the grounds that it was wholly without precedent in either international law or the domestic laws of any of the Allies, the Nuremberg trials had a great influence on the development of international criminal law. The conclusions of the Nuremberg trial served as models for it. This resulted in the establishment of a permanent international criminal court. In conclusion, the military tribunal and the Nuremberg trials were based on the principles of American justice